being in an arts community helps attract people who are already aware of fair trade and are making more conscious and ethical decisions about their purchasing. So they're interested in artists and artisans and handmade goods.
The Shortmouth was our third store that we opened up. We had opened two other stores, and the Shortmouth was always a place we wanted to get to right from the beginning of the company. In Columbus, it's where so many great brands and local restaurants and so many events are happening down there. It really is like the center of the city, both from a geographical but also from an energy and event standpoint. So always our goal right from the beginning, get down to Shortmouth as soon as we could. It's been a big part of Columbus's identity to have the Shortmouth. It's usually a part they write about in the New York Times, or Chicago Tribune is going to do a travel blog about places you need to visit. They almost always mention the Shortmouth as the place where you're going to start this. The neighborhood has grown so much over the years. Lots of art galleries down there. We still have most of those left, and there's even been some new ones added. And I always try to encourage people to think more broadly about art. I think the peach and ricotta appetizer at Forno is art. I think the cocktails at Mouton are art. I think there's live music being produced. The interior design of the Guildhouse restaurant down there is art. All those things, to me, if you broaden your definition of art from just paintings on the wall of a storefront devoted to showing those galleries, you realize that that is still such a dense collection of the best of what Columbus has to offer from an artistic standpoint, that we're just incredibly proud to be a part of that neighborhood and a part of crafting that to be the identity of the city for most of our visitors.
So we're a nonprofit organization, and our mission is fair trade. Fair trade basically means everything in the store is handmade, and all the artisans earn fair wages for their work. And I've seen Columbus really grow and bloom by providing opportunities to local artists. Definitely over the last two decades, I've seen not only the arts community grow, but also business community, entrepreneurship, and we're attracting a lot of new people from all over the country who are coming here for the opportunities that the Shortmouth provides.
It's a way for the federal government to acknowledge that there's lots of things that are important in this country, and we fund them, and the arts is one of those things. So
I think it's unfortunate that our government's not valuing the arts, that our schools are not valuing the arts as much, because research shows that children who are educated in music and fine art, they actually perform better in math and sciences. So the arts are very important to our development and to our expression, you know, as a as people, our humanity.
Scientific research and national defense and education, healthcare, these are all things that get federal dollars, and it's all a way of the federal government investing in things to keep those issues moving forward and to also show, like, this is what we believe in as a country. So when it comes to arts funding, it's incredibly important from a symbolic standpoint to say this is, you know, we think the arts are an important part of what makes our country great, and we're going to fund and support it.